information reaching us is that this woman, the minister of Elehan Abel Humanitarian Affairs, Beta Edu, say Tinubu don't suspend them. Say president don't suspend them. Why? Because she tried to divert 585 million naira meant for the poor. What they say they want share to people inside Lagos, Cross River, and some other places like four or five states, I think. He divert them to personal account instead of the ministry account. So because of them now, they say if they undergo investigation. So Tinubu don't suspend them. If you know Christ, say suspend. They for not suspend them. They for just call for investigation, and she go still dey there. Do you know what they sweet me about this matter? Now, BKO of TVC. Mona say BKO. BKO will be like say, as Tinubu enter office, you know, can they talk through again? But when BKO talk on top of this matter, I can say, hey, whoa, BKO. So you can still speak the truth. I thought you have sold your conscience. I think say you don't swallow something that is very difficult for you to vomit. So you can speak the truth in this matter. You're not like, hey, better, hey, do it well, hey, hey, hey. Yeah, this guy talk through. See, that day your screen, BKO of TVs. I beg. The guy shocked me. Oh. Make gonna help me listen to what BKO talk on top of this matter. As he take touch, say, this woman divert money, go personal account, money that is meant for the poor of the poorest. Go watch.
Let's move on to what is going on in that ministry. This ministry appears to be a ministry simply created for some individuals to steal money meant for the poorest of the poor. It is the most unconscionable thing to do, to divert money meant to make life a little meaningful for the poorest of the poor in our society. You steal money meant for them. You have no heaven to go to. It's as simple as that. That is what's going on in that ministry. Now, the minister, the immediate past minister, is being investigated for 37 billion. And that's why she has a date with the EFCC. She's going nowhere. When the time comes, she will still have to face the EFCC and explain what she knows. But the focus on that ministry is yielding a lot of things. In fact, it's now showing to us that, amongst themselves, they are even leaking secrets about themselves. Look at what has happened with the current Minister of Humanitarian Affairs. I'm disappointed that a woman of better education will go to the extent of writing to the Accountant General of the Federation to transfer more than 580 million naira meant for the poorest of the poor in Akwa Ibom, Lagos, and some other states to be posted into the private account, into the account of an individual that she described as the project accountant. What is the meaning of project accountant? Hasn't that agency got its own account? I mean, this is a big scandal, because the immediate past, the national coordinator for the conditional cash transfer is being investigated, as has even been suspended from her position, from her current position in this administration, because of the allegation that funds were diverted into private accounts under her watch. It's exactly the same thing that Beta Edu wanted the Accountant General to do. Thank God, because as I was preparing for this program, I saw that the Accountant General actually didn't release the money. Despite the fact that Beta Edu was trying to explain away what has happened, how do you want Nigerians to believe that it was right to move 580 million into a private account? How on earth? And you had the guts to even be explaining that, it is not illegal within civil service laws. Which law permits you to move bond funds into private accounts from government coffers. There's no such law. No regulation permits that kind of thing to take place. In fact, it's seen as a serious procurement and fiscal malfeasance. And if we say we want to tackle corruption in our country, this sort of thing should never be allowed to happen. We will defeat corruption when we make it impossible for individuals to even go that far. Now, since he's saying it does not infringe on any law, I wonder how much he knows about our laws, because he's a medical doctor. It infringes on Public Procurement and Fiscal Responsibility Act, the Independent Corrupt Practices and Other Offenses Act, and the Code of Conduct Act. It is also in breach of the anti-money laundering Prohibition Act. So who says it was right for Better Ego to say that you go and move 580 million into an individual's account? The question is, that individual, if the money was moved into our account, we should pay tax on the money? We see? How do you even monitor compliance when the money is sitting in somebody's private account? How do you do that?
Oh, now don't see him. That same thing where I talk for one of my content, one of my presentation, you understand, recently, I talk and say, Ministry of Humanitarian Affairs was carefully carved out to steal, to thief, to launder money, all in the name of, who want to help the poor, who want to help the poor. Lie. Abia Ashia, 5,000, 20,000 naira. Whereas millions, billions of naira is being looted in the name of helping the poor. The other woman, Omar Farouk, that was there during Buhari's regime, said it on the column, says, Oga, come and answer to EFCC. She never won't come. She deformed sick. Now, this Better Edu, this woman, I know she said she don't reach 40. You don't need thief already. You say, may they carry money, put for private account. You won't share. What happens to the ministry account so that there can be accountability? What? Now, personal account. When I hear what BKO talk, that personal account where they won't pay this money into, the account go pay tax. Like, how they go take monitor, how they take use the money? You say, may the accountant general pay the money into private account. What happen to your ministry account? I be the ministry no get account. Better he do. You see, all these women, where did this government? See them? Yellow popo, I don't know. Yellow popo, this one now. He won't use this government shine. You won't loot what you won't loot. Medical doctor, for that matter, trained abroad. You come back here, you don't get human sympathy. Money where they suppose use help the poorest of the poor. Now you say, they put for personal account. So you go loot them. Go thief them. Not be the same issue now. Not be this guy to make you get issue inside Cross River State with your governor. Ayade. We are here. They say Ayade even sack you that time. Maybe now you be, I'm thinking Ayade the in charge of the Ministry of Health. Where Ayade sack you. Maybe now because of this matter, they sack you that time. Because they play better person inside APC. They call Nike Humanitarian Affairs. Now see, my money won't loot. Loot. Go better your life. You never reach 40. Young woman, don't carry the mentality of thieving inside your head. Say, BKO, thank you very much. I don't know if you talk through like this. I just say, as Tinubu don't enter now and Tinubu gets TVC, you have sold your conscience to speaking whatever that will favor the government of Tinubu. I don't know if you talk through like this. Hope you are going to continue on this line. Don't deviate to, if you see through talk, and why would we like you before? Before you come, they do, anyhow. Oh, now they hear me. Better Edu. I don't want to see that this woman came out to that office. Because she has not denied that the money, she asked for the money to be paid into a private. She has not denied it. So that means it happened. We no one see her near any ministry. May she go back, go the lead her women people inside APC. Now women leadership, go back there and be leading your women. Don't come to anything where concern ministry again. Tinubu, you don't hear me. I go see on her later.
Imagine a country where its citizens get to enjoy the road without this. Imagine a country where unprecedented fuel scarcity does not cause panic, at the filling station. That is why Innocent Vehicles has embarked on manufacturing environmental friendly gas-powered cars while still offering comfort, luxury, and doggedness for the African roads. Innocent Vehicles, the pride of African roads.